Okay, we have understood what discretization means and we have looked at the Taylor series. Let me rewrite it again. If I have a function and I want to find out the value of the function at delta x location, provided I know that the value of the function at location x, I can expand this into an infinite series. I have delta x times dou f by dou x plus delta x square times 2 factorial dou square f by dou x square plus delta x cube by 3 factorial, the third partial derivative of f, and so on. This goes on till infinity. Let me consider a grid, a two-dimensional grid. Let me say that this is location x, this is x plus delta x, and this is x minus delta x. Similarly, I can have location y here, y minus delta y here, and y plus delta y here. It is convenient in CFD to denote all these locations with indices. Let's say I'm denoting the x indices with I. Hence, this will become I plus 1. And the point left to I will be I minus 1. And let me denote all the indices in Y with index j. So this would be j minus 1 point, j plus 1 line or points. So this would be point I comma j corresponding to x comma y location. This point corresponds to x plus delta x comma y plus delta y, or in the index notation I plus 1 comma j plus 1. Let's say I want to write this infinite Taylor series for a flow variable u. U could be any flow variable, not only velocity. I can write this in index form, u of, what is x plus delta x, I plus 1, u of I plus 1 is equal to, what is fx, that is location of u at I, can write it as u at location I, plus, I have delta x, times, dou f by dou x, if you recollect, it is the derivative at location x. So I can write dou u by dou x at location. Okay, let me write I plus 1 comma j, I comma j, and this is at I comma j location, plus delta x square by 2 factorial dou square u by dou x square at location I comma j at this point, and so on. So this is the same expression or same infinite series in index terms. Now let's continue and get some flow variables. If you recollect, in our Navier-Stokes equations and in our governing equations, we had all terms like dou u by dou x, dou t by dou y. So essentially we had dou square u by dou x square, dou p by dou x, or dou p by dou y. So all the terms in our governing equations are first order derivatives or second order derivatives. So we are interested in finding out this term, or this term and this term. These are what we need. So we will manipulate this equation in such a way, this expression in such a way, that we will get some plausible approximations for dou u by dou x and dou square u by dou x square.